I'm Andrea Zille, researcher of the Center of Textile Science and Technology at the University of Minho, and vice president of Hipacia, the Association of the Italian Researcher in Portugal. I'm here today to talk about the protective disposal face mask. Like that. World Health Organization still recommend people not to wear face masks unless they are sick with COVID-19 or caring for someone who is sick. Masks may actually increase the risk to catching the virus if used improperly. You should wear a mask and seek medical attention if you have cough, fever, and difficult breathing. But if you are healthy, you only need to wear a mask if you are taking care of a person with COVID-19. Masks should only be used by healthcare workers. There is no specific evidence to suggest that the wearing of a mask by the mass population has any potential benefits. In fact, there is some evidence to suggest the opposite in the misuse of wearing a mask properly or fitting it properly. If you wear a mask, then you must know how to use it and dispose of it properly. Despite the WHO recommendation, several countries have decided that during the slow returning to normality, general population have to compulsorily use the mask in closed space, public transport, and workplaces. In Europe, the precautionary principle prevailed, and as recommended by the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control, the Portuguese Directorate General Health, or DGS, is now recommending the widespread use of masks by the general population. But remember, mask alone is insufficient to provide an adequate level of protection and must be used in combination with frequent hand cleaning with alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. This video is intended to give an answer to the most important doubt related with this topic. How many types of disposable masks exist? How do they work? And how to put on and remove properly a face mask? There are two different types of masks, surgical masks and respirator. The surgical mask, it's a medical equipment. It protects the patient from spreading droplets in the vicinity. It also protects the wearer from droplets produced by a person directly in front of them. However, depending on the circumstances, it does not protect from inhaling the very small particles suspended in the air that could potentially carry the virus. Surgical mask with an additional waterproof layer can also protect the wearer from the risk of splashes of biological fluids. This mask should not be worn for more than 3 to 8 hours, depending on the use. Individual respirator protection masks are designed to protect the wearer against the inhalation of both droplet and particles suspended in air. These type of masks are more restrictive than the surgical mask, forming a seal around the face and causing higher discomfort and breathing resistance, but it can protect from inhaling infectious pathogens. Respirator masks can be divided in 3 categories, FFP1, 2, and 3. FFP1 masks offer the lowest level of protection, similar to a surgical mask. It's mainly used as a dust mask. Manufacturers use yellow elastic bands to identify this type of mask. The aerosol filtration percentage is 80% minimum, and the internal leak rate, which is the quantity of air going outside without being filtered, is maximum 22. FFP2 mask, or N95 for the American standard, can be identified by a white or blue elastic band. The aerosol filtration percentage is not less than 94%, and the internal leak rate is maximum 8%. This mask offers effectively protection to stop powered chemicals, bacteria, and virus. It is the most used by the healthcare workers. It guarantees very high level of filtration efficiency while maintaining a good breathing comfort. FFP3 or N99 for the American standard use red elastic bands for identification. The aerosol filtration percentage is not less than 99%, and the internal leak rate is maximum 2%. The FFP3 mask is the most filtering of the FFP masks. It protects very fine particles such as asbestos and ceramic, but it does not protect against gases. However, they can be more difficult to breathe through. To facilitate breathing, both FFP2 and FFP3 masks can be fitted with outer valves. However, the virus could come out through the valves and for this reason are not recommended for use by infected persons. Just a note, for the handmade masks, a textile fabric is going to filter out less than 10% of the particles. Even when you use a several layer of fabric, it may have two main pores. A mask of cotton or paper can protect the others if worn by someone sick to prevent the dispersion of large droplets, but it does not protect from inhaling or spreading the virus contained in the aerosol. Face masks are made of several layers of a nonwoven polymer, usually polypropylene, made of fiber with small diameters. Nonwoven fabrics are broadly defined as sheets of web structure mechanically, thermically, or chemically bonded together by entangling randomly oriented fiber or filaments. To get through a filter made out of interlaced layer of polypropylene fibers, small particles have to wind through a tortuous path and as a result tend to get stuck. However, masks have more than one filtering mechanism. Filtration through a mask happens following three general mechanisms: inertial impacton, diffusion, and electrostatic attraction. Inertial impacton works for particles that are larger than 1 micron. Such particles are too large to weave through the mask fibers and end up physically blocked by the fiber. The mechanism called diffusion helps keep particles that are 0.1 micron and smaller from proceeding. The design of the mask filters create a situation in which these small particles move in random direction, colliding with each other and with filter fibers. The third mechanism is the electrostatic attraction. During the manufacturing process, the fiber receives an electric charge. This allows the filter material not only physically block the virus, but also to electrostatically attract the virus so that it gets stuck on the fiber. How to put on a face mask? Firstly, wash your hand before touching the mask. Then, remove the mask from the box and make sure there is not visible damage. The side of the mask that has a bendable strip is the top and is meant to mold to the shape of your nose. In the case of surgical mask, determine which side of the mask is the front. The colored side of the mask is usually the front and should face away from you, while the white side touch your face. For surgical masks, place a loop around each ear. For face mask with bands, hold the mask in your hand with the nose piece on top of the mask at the fingertips. Bring the mask to your nose level, pull the top strap over your head so that it rests over the crown of your head. Pull the bottom strap over your head so that it rests at the nape of your neck. Mold or pinch the stiff edge of the shape of your nose. Pull the bottom of the mask over your mouth and chin. How to remove a face mask? Wash your hand before touching the mask. Avoid touching the front of the mask because it's contaminated. Only touch the ear loops or bands. For surgical mask, hold both of the ear loops and gently lift and remove the mask. For face mask with bands, lift the bottom strap over your head first, then pull the top strap over your head. Throw away the mask immediately in a closed bin. Wash your hand again. That's all. I hope you have enjoyed the first edition of the Hipacia Pills. See you soon. Stay young. Stay safe.